Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope you're all staying safe and well. We've got an unboxing to do. This one's from MotionRC EU and it's by Freewing. This will be replacing my Rebel. So the Rebel is off to the shop today. This one is going to be unboxed, built and flown in place of the Rebel. What is it? Well, let's get this outer packaging out of the way and see what we've got underneath. Well, I'm replacing a sports jet with a sports jet, but I think this one looks much better. And hopefully it will fly better. It should. This has a high speed of 131 miles an hour, according to Freewing. Wingspan just over the meter. The length just over 1.1 meters. And it's 1.5 kilograms without the battery. First of all, let's see how it's packed. It's Freewing, so it should be packed really well in the foam. Almost all of the items should be covered in their own plastic. Yeah, never disappointed with Freewing. They pack stuff so well. It's a bit like FMS, they have it down to an art. Well, there we are. That's the underside of it, obviously. Packed away really nicely. Everything's protected separately. There's some extra stuff. Let's take a look at it up close and personal. So we've got the Vulcan manual. This is the electronic speed controller information. I can just go over there. Here's the manual, 70mm sports jet. Page 1 to 9 is English. 10 to 18 is Chinese. Well, you've got the 4S Lite or 6S Pro. I have the 6S Pro. There's all screwing, no gluing on this one. Four screws for the tailplane. Four screws for the fin and rudder. Four screws for the main wing. And that's it. They're showing a 4000 milliamp, 6S 4000 milliamp battery. Oh, they've got two recommendations of battery here. One is for the 4S and one is for the 6S. The capacities are exactly the same. The discharge rating is exactly the same. The only difference is one's a 4S, one's a 6S. And then we've got the 6S. Central gravity. Now this is a bit of a silly complaint, but they have marked this center of gravity. They have marked it dead center on the fuselage. And the way it's marked is there is a little line which looks great on this diagram. The problem is that it's covered in tape. And we'll see that. And also, you don't balance your model here. Movements, aileron, elevator, rudder, flaps. And that's it. With this, you get some additional stickers. So if you'd like to give MotionRC free advertising, you can shove one of these on. If you want to give Freewing free advertising, you can shove one of these on. Yeah. Don't think I'll be doing any of that. I might use the 70mm sports jet sticker. That's the warning thing that comes with it. Here we have a nose. I love the mustard colour of this. So we've got a nose with some stickers, magnets and a tongue. Because it goes into a tongue and groove and the magnet holds it in place. It's also got a plastic tip so you can store it on its nose and the foam's not going to be deformed. There it is, one nose. Everything comes in its bags. Some bags are sealed. Generally the fuselage bag isn't, but these are. I also like the fact that they cut a slit in the bags and they push the wires out. So these wires cannot rub up against the actual paintwork or the decals on this model. All right, so here we are. with the fin and rudder and water slide decals. Lovely. They're not stickers, they're water slide decals. Lovely mustard colour. That's the colour I'm calling it. Great big long lead here, so you do need a go get 'em wire, which we've got. I'll show you that in a minute. Plastic bits here, you screw into plastic to hold this in. Servo in, mounted, plate over it. This is nice, this is very nice. It has standard clevises going into the horns. Now, if you look at this, they've actually put it in on the second hole down, not automatically to the top one. That's interesting. It has both compressed foam hinges and 1, 2, 3, because it's under the decal, real hinges. That is nice. See the hinges here? Shouldn't do that. Don't do that. Yeah, very nice. All right, look, this, I don't know why they do this. We go through this every time I do a Freewing unboxing. These are those plastic DIY hinges. Therefore, when you start seeing a tear and things in your foam hinges, you can think about cutting it off and putting these in. They're not for doing it before you start to notice any damage. To be quite honest, I would never use these, and if I was going to put a real hinge in, I'd go and buy a decent hinge, not something like this that you Okay, another sealed bag, this time with the tailplane and elevator. And here we are with the tailplane and elevator. How do we put that on? Flushes it out too much. All paint, all one colour paint with water slide decal sets. Some more very long servo wires. These are probably, again, going to need a go-get-em hook to bring them through the fuselage. These are left and right elevator servos. The elevator, as with the rudder, has real hinging in it. Lovely. 1, 2, 3. It's also got the foam hinge there. Nice. Shouldn't really do that, but there we go. Servos, plates, wiring. It goes that way. There's not much else to say about it. It's very nice. Double screws, which you should expect. Sometimes they have four, sometimes they have two. But nice big plates, horns, clevis, fuel tubing on the clevis, Z-bend into the second holes down on the horns, as well as the second holes on the horns for the elevator. So the servo horn's in hole two, as is the elevator. We will check that in the manual to see if that's correct, because it will affect the movements. Then we have a little goodie bag here, and as with everything Freewing, it's all listed what's in it. So we have a tiny piece of non-slip matting. It's a nice gesture, but I won't be using it. I've got my own, I'll either use Velcro or my own matting. Then we have some countersunk screws, four of those. And we have some round-headed screws, eight of those, and two clevis. They're not very nice clevises, with a bit of fuel tubing around them. Nice. Here, if you can see it, we have a go-get-em wire. And all it is, it's bent in a particular way that you can put the servo lead through there. You push it in through the fuselage, put the servo lead through there, and then you pull it back. And that's it. That's all that's used for. I've got a couple somewhere, but why go fishing for them when they provide one with every model that needs it? Look at this. This is awesome. Wow. Okay, so it is all paint. You've got flaps. You've got ailerons. You've got shiny, sticky, reflective stuff here on top of water slide transfers. Yeah, nice. Right, lots of wires here, as you'd expect. Got landing gear, aileron, and flaps from each wing. Let's turn it over, take a look. This is the business end. Look at that. Interesting thing here is I have seen these, the Vulcan, in this colour, where the aileron is in fact notched, hinged. These are hinged. But that is brilliant. So you've got flaps that are also hinged, ailerons that are hinged, horns, push rods, servos, clevises, fuel tubing on the clevises, all in place. Retracts look really good. Retracts. They're the sprung type. Got spring there for the retracts, very nice. And here, if you can see it, is that CG mark. Just under there, that piece of tape, it says CG. What you could do, it looks like it's the bottom line of the trench for the wires here. So I suppose you could, yeah, that should be okay to mark. So it's from there to there is the centre of gravity. Wheels, yeah, wow, they're nice and trim at the moment. Same on the other side. The other side has got a transfer on it. Vulcan 70mm sports jet, which would go with the additional sticker on the fuse. Horns and clevises, all connected. Servos, exactly the same as the other side. Hinges, 1, 2, 3. Flap hinges, 1, 2, 3. Look at that. That is so nice. Yeah. These are blocks for your screws to screw this wing in place. That is nice. I like that. That is very nice. Do bear in mind that this came out 2 years ago, and when it came out 2 years ago, these, the ailerons, were definitely just foam hinges, as were the elevators and as were the rudders. So in that 2 years, they've made some changes, although they didn't re-release it as a V2 or V3. They've just incorporated the changes, and all for the better, as far as I'm concerned, all for the better. So let's take a look at this fuselage that I am totally in love with. Look at that. But Martin, you say it looks similar to the Rebel. Well, not really. The Rebel's cockpit was a hump, and it had a hump on the back, and then it went down. This is sleek all the way down. Not only that, this is plastic covered foam. Let me put the other light on. Look how shiny that is. I love it. Absolutely love it. It's all paint except where it isn't. And what I mean by that is these look like water slide decals, but they might possibly be stickers on the side. Yeah, they look like stickers, to be honest. But they're very nice. This is a sticker. This Freewing here. And you can get the other ones that people put MotionRC along here or Freewing. I won't do any of that. But I will use the 70mm sports sport jet. Is it 70mm sport jet or 70mm sports jet? Dunno. Well, I've got a sport jet. So that's what I'll be going along here somewhere, I guess. Both sides. Let's look at this. Retracts in there, again, sprung. Take a look at this. Here we have the... Well, now, wow, I've just noticed something that's really interesting with this one. This section here is the same on the Rebel. Well, it's the same design, but the Rebel had slits in it here. There's nothing. This is solid. Also, there's no cheat holes anywhere on this. It's got no cheat holes there. And the wing itself has no cheat holes. And my understanding is this doesn't need cheat holes. It can suck enough air in and push enough out without needing cheat holes, which is very nice. It looks like it's got a Freewing 80 amp. It says 3-6S V2 speed controller. And I do like the way they just screw them up on this board at the top. And back there is a lovely looking 70mm 12 blade fan unit. I'll be able to see it better through here. There you go. And that's an in-runner motor. It's lovely. It's really nice. I was worried it would be too yellow, but it's actually a nice mustard colour. I've got my big spotlight on it, but if I turn it off, you can see the colour better there. It's a mustard. It's definitely not yellow. This, though, I love this. I just love it. Look at the shine on that. Anyway, it doesn't fly from a canopy. See, it's foam. It's bleeding out again. Let me turn that one down. I've got to adjust these lights. Now, look at there. That's better. See the foam? Foam ribbing. This is where I was really impressed with this. That board is for your receiver. All of this is for your receiver. Battery goes in here. You can move it backwards and forwards. And it has one of these blue flight line connection junction boxes. Everything coming into the model, but they are all clearly marked. Also, they are clearly marked where the signal is. And the signal is on the inside pin on both sides. And you just plug everything into that box. It's got a sticky back M3 back. And when you've done it, you just shove it away somewhere, tuck it away down there. It's not a gyro, so it can be orientated any place you like. And if you ask me, there's a place that's natural for it just down there. It just sits there naturally. So this is all free for your battery. Oh, what a shame. I have to send it back now. It's got one of these horrible EC5s on it. No, I've got a converter for that. I can handle that. The other nice thing here is the board is not glued in. It's screwed in. I can take that up, put some anti-slip matting on it, screw it back down, and job is done. Lovely. This is great. Now that's all you see in there at the moment. Loads of space. Loads of space. It's got a shelf right up the top there. Don't know if you can see that. I might have to turn my light up a bit. And then I'll bleach everything out. But it's got a shelf right at the top. And that's where you push the go get them. It's above the speed controller. So the speed controller is there with that board. You're actually above that. And the wires all come down this backbone through there for the tail section. Yeah, it's really nice. What am I trying to do here? Pass there. I like the latches. Bit old school, but I do like them. This will be put together really quickly because today I am taking the Rebel to the model store, put it in the second-hand cave, and it should go pretty quickly. This will take its place. For the Banshee, I crashed the Banshee. Just as a reminder for everyone, this is what happened. I'm still looking for those two cameras that I lost. Every time I go up the field, I just walk over to that area, spend half an hour just milling around, seeing if one day I'll spot something. If I do, I'll put the video up and let you see from the other angles. But to replace the Banshee, I have something a little bit special as far as I'm concerned. You'll have to wait and see. The next time I go up the field, I'm taking the same set of models that I took up for my session 6, I think it was, where I only flew the Banshee and crashed it. They'll all be the same models, except there will be one additional, which is my Banshee replacement. This Vulcan is a Rebel replacement. Confused, you soon will be. Only thing that remains is to say thank you for watching. Stay safe, stay well. And I look forward to you coming and joining me on another video soon.